Idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis, also known as IPF, is a chronic progressive lung disease that causes scarring or fibrosis in the lung tissue. Although IPF is called idiopathic, which means of an unknown cause, there are many known risk factors of IPF. These include genetic factors, exposures such as smoking or viral exposures, and gastroesophageal reflux. Each patient's risk factors are different, and some may not be known yet or identifiable, but the end result is pulmonary fibrosis. The symptoms of IPF can start gradually, most often with shortness of breath with exertion, dry cough, or fatigue. These symptoms can also be seen in a number of other lung or heart problems, which makes IPF difficult to diagnose. As IPF progresses, many patients have low oxygen levels, first with exertion and then with the need to use supplemental oxygen for support. IPF is diagnosed by a pulmonologist who will take a thorough and careful history of symptoms, occupation, and environment. They'll also perform a physical examination and do some testing. Testing for IPF includes pulmonary function testing, lab work, and a special type of lung X-ray called a high-resolution computed tomography, or HRCT scan. Putting all of this information together can lead to the diagnosis in many patients. But some patients may need an additional procedure called a lung biopsy. Treatments for IPF can be thought of in two ways, as those that are disease-specific, meaning that they are intended to slow down the progression of IPF, and those that are considered supportive care. Supportive care treatments include supplemental oxygen, when appropriate, pulmonary rehabilitation, and management of symptoms such as cough and shortness of breath. There are two medications that have been shown to be effective at slowing down the disease progression in IPF, nintedanib and pirfenidone. These medications do not reverse pulmonary fibrosis or treat the symptoms, but they are able to slow down the decline in lung function. For some patients with rapidly progressive or later stage disease, lung transplantation can be a treatment option. People often hear or read that patients with IPF only live 3 to 5 years after diagnosis. This is an outdated estimate, since patients with IPF are being diagnosed earlier, and we now have effective disease-slowing medications. That said, IPF is a progressive but unpredictable disease. There are some patients who have a very slow decline in lung function and can live much longer than 5 years, and there are others who have a more aggressive disease course that can progress in a matter of months. Determining the prognosis in an individual patient can be challenging, especially at the time of diagnosis. Even those patients who have had a more stable disease course are at risk for flare-ups or what is medically known as acute exacerbation. This is an episode of rapid worsening of shortness of breath and the oxygen levels that often requires hospitalization. While much has been learned about IPF, there is more work to be done. Research is ongoing to better understand the factors that contribute to the development of the disease and to the development of more effective therapies. For more information and support, please visit pulmonaryfibrosis.org.